Hey guys, in this video I am going to discuss with you types of operating system. Okay, so mainly I'll discuss five types of operating system. Those are written on the board, and other than these operating types of operating system, there are network operating system also, distributed operating system also, and mobile operating system you can say, or single user operating system, multi user operating system. Okay, so but in this video I'm going to discuss only these types of operating system, network and distributed operating system. I'll discuss in next video. Okay, now first is, what is batch operating system? Now, as the name suggests, batch, what this batch means, you can see if there is a class of 60 students, then for theory all the 60 students were there, and when you are going for your lab class, then you are divided into batches, maybe two batches, that even batch will go on Monday, A2 batch will go on Tuesday, like this. So batch is what? In batch you have 30 students. So like this, in this operating system also, we don't have students, we have what? Jobs. So batch will be having many jobs. Okay, now what is a job? Job is, you know, it's a program plus input data plus control instructions. This complete is known as a job. When you study this batch operating system, then you will always find this word job. You will not find a program, because job is what? Program plus input data. It's not just a program. Program plus input data also, plus control instruction also. Okay. See, now this batch operating system were non-interactive. Non-interactive means a user cannot interact with those systems or these type of operating systems. Okay. Now what user used to do, if user want to perform some task, then user used to prepare their job in the form of on punch cards. Okay, punch card is something like it's a kind of this type of card, and they punches would be there in this card. They perform the job with the help of this type of punches, and if punch is there, then light will pass from this hole, and it would be considered as maybe binary 1, and if light doesn't pass, then it would be considered at binary 0. So user used to prepare their job in this type of pattern, and in the system, card readers were there, and used to insert their jobs in the form of punch cards to the card reader, and then card reader read what is written on this punch card. Okay, now what is the funda of batch operating system? These type of operating systems were non-interactive. A user cannot interact with operating system. As you see in this diagram, between user and this operating system we have one operator. Operator is also a person, and this operator will interact with this system, okay, with their operating system. Okay, now user used to prepare their jobs in the form of, or you can say, on punch cards, and they submit their jobs to operator. Okay, and they used to leave. Operator used to sort these jobs according to their needs. Okay, or you can say the nature of job. Similar kinds of job were bundled and in one batch, and another similar kinds of job were bundled in another batch, something like this. Okay, suppose these J1, J3, J5 and J6, you can say maybe these can be grouped because these are written in Fortran language, all the jobs, and these are written in COBOL language. Okay, so the batches would be formed on the basis of their needs, or you can say their nature. Similar kinds of job were grouped in one batch. Fine. And now these batches would be inserted. Batches means you can say it's a deck of punch cards, because job is in the form of punch cards. Fine. So here is one punch card, another punch card, third punch card and fourth punch card, like this. And user used to do what? User used to insert batch by batch. Batch 1, all the punch cards of these J1, J3, J5, J6 at one time, operator used to insert this batch into system, or you can say operating system. After that, operating system would do, what the operating system will do, process this batch. And after the completion of this process, this batch, only that time batch B2 can be inserted in this system. Fine. See, why this job is having program plus input output data plus control instructions? Because the system is non-interactive. So at the starting, user will feed all the all things, what is the program, what the input data and what are the control instructions. Fine. At starting only, a user prepare the job having all the three things, and then this job would be inserted into your system. And after batch 1 completes, only then the batch 2 would be inserted, and output is also in the form of punch cards. Fine. So this loading of punch cards and then unloading of these punch cards from the data, it used to take time, and during that time CPU remains idle. So that is why in batch operating system CPU utilization was very low. Fine. Because everybody knows the CPU speed of CPU is faster than obviously that input output devices. So when one batch is to be inserted manually, then obviously it will take time, and then unloading is also take time. Till then CPU is idle. So that is why CPU utilization was very low. And until the completion of batch 1, the operator cannot insert what, batch 2. Fine. So now the, you know, some modifications were there in this operating system, and next operating system is multi-programming operating system. Now what is there in multi-programming operating system? See, as the name suggests, multiple programs, or you can say multiple processes, would be there in main memory. Fine. Like this, suppose we have 3 processes in the main memory, and here we have one CPU. And suppose at one particular time the CPU has been allocated to process P1. Now P1 is executing, and in between, suppose now after some time P1 requires some input output device. So suppose P1 is doing some IO operations, and during this time there is no process in the CPU. Fine. Now what is this funda? At this time P2 would be there, means CPU would be allocated to next process who is ready to execute. Fine. P1 is doing some IO operation, P1 is not there now in CPU. P1 is here doing some IO operation, and now P2 is in this CPU. Fine. But see, it was not the funda in batch operating system. Batch operating system, we can't do this kind of thing. Okay. So if suppose P2 also needs some IO operation. Fine. Now P2 is not there in CPU. Now P3, CPU can be allocated to this process P3, like this. Okay. That is why it is known as multiple programming. So in this case, CPU utilization is, you know, increased. Now another thing about this multi-programming is, suppose P1 has been allocated, their CPU has been allocated to process P1. Fine. Now until the termination of this P1, we cannot forcefully remove this P1 from the CPU and can allocate the CPU to some other process. Fine. P1 can leave the CPU itself if P1 wants to do some IO operation, then itself P1 can go for IO operation, then only P2 can be there, then only CPU can be allocated to P2. But forcefully we cannot remove P1 while executing and then allocate the CPU to P2. Fine. Now see, drawback is what? Suppose P1 is taking very long time. So P1 is suppose taking 1 hour, and P2 require only 15 seconds to complete. So P2 has to wait for 1 hour, although it is a small process, but it has to wait for 1 hour. Fine. So this is the drawback of this multi-programming. We cannot remove this P1 and thus just allocate this CPU to this P2. Fine. Now next, See this multitasking. Now this multitasking is extension of multi-programming. Now what is there in multitasking? Suppose we have more than one process, multiple process in the main memory, and we have CPU and CPU has been allocated to P1 suppose, fine. Now what is there in multitasking? You can forcefully remove this P1 from the CPU and you can allocate the CPU to P2. On what basis? On the basis of time slot. In this case, some time quantum would be allocated to each process. Okay. Suppose P1 requires 10 seconds, P2 requires 5 seconds, and P3 requires only 2 seconds to execute. And time quantum given is 2 seconds. Now, CPU has been allocated to P1, fine. Now, after 2 seconds, we remove this P1 from the CPU and P1 would wait again to its ready queue. Now, CPU would be allocated to next, that is P2. And only for 2 seconds. Fine. But still P2 requires how many seconds more? 3 seconds to complete its task. But we forcefully remove this P2 and it will wait again in queue and then P3 would come. P3 would come only for 2 seconds, but P3 only required 2 seconds, so P3 means you can say P3 has been completed and P3 would be terminated now. Now again after P3, now again from this queue, P1 would be, CPU would be allocated to P1, but for 2 seconds only. And if P1 still needs some time for its completion, then it would wait in this queue. This is the funda of this multitasking, or you can say time sharing, or it is also known as fair share, or it is also known as multi-programming with round robin. Fine. So this is extension of multi-programming. What was there in multi-programming? We cannot remove, if P1 requires 10 seconds for its completion, then P1 would execute for 10 seconds only. We cannot remove this before 10 seconds. See, it can itself remove, itself leave the CPU if it wants some input-output devices or input-output operation, but user or the operating system cannot forcefully remove this in case of multi-programming. But in multitasking it is possible because of this time quantum. Now next is multi-processing. So before going to this multi-processing, I want to tell you one more point about multitasking. See, because of this multitasking only you feel that multiple processes are running at the same time, but actually that is not true. CPU can be allocated to one process at one time. It is not like that P1 is also executing, P2 is also executing at the same time. That is not possible. But it seems that multiple processes are running. Like if you are listening song, you are typing something on Word, and as well as you are browsing something on internet, and many background processes are also running at the same time. Fine. But it is not like that all the processes are running parallelly. It's because of time quantum only. They are switching. See, operating system manage this thing. Operating system allocates CPU for some particular time quantum to each process. And then switching, context switching is to be there between these processes. And though this context switching is so fast, very quick, it seems that all the processes are running parallelly, but actually that is not true. Now next is multiprocessing. See, here in multiprogramming and multitasking, we have discussed these two with the help of one CPU only. Fine. Here we have only one CPU, but in multiprocessing, multiple CPUs would be there, more than one CPU. So if multiple CPUs are there, then you can say more than one process can be executed parallelly. See, here we have CPU 1, CPU 2, CPU 3. Suppose 3 CPUs are there, fine. And we have P1, P2, P3, P4, in our main memory. We have four processes in our main memory. So P1, CPU 1 could be allocated to P1. At the same time, CPU 2 could be allocated to P2. This could be allocated to P3, like this. So at same time, multiple processes are running. But that was not the case in multitasking and multiprogramming. Only one, if one CPU is there, only one process can execute at the same time. See here, one CPU, in this CPU only one process is there. We cannot say here P1 and P2. That is wrong. Fine. Here multiple processes are running because we have multiple CPUs in our PC. One PC, we have multiple CPUs. That is multiprocessing basically. And it is different from multi-computer. In multiprocessing, only one computer is there. Within one computer, multiple CPUs are there. Multiple that cores are there. Fine. But in multi-computer, multiple computers are there. One computer, two computer, three computer, and these are connected having their individual CPUs. That is multi-computer. Multiprocessing is within one computer, multiple processors are there. I guess you might have heard that dual core processor means two cores are there, two processors are there. Quad core means four processor, octa core means eight processor, like this. So this is multiprocessing. Okay. Now, next is real-time operating system. See here basically time bound would be there. These are used in real-time applications. Two types of operating system are there. One is soft real-time and one is hard real-time operating system. Now in soft real-time operating system, the processes should be completed within the time bound. And in hard real-time operating system, the process should be completed at exact time. So in these type of operating system, time constraint is there. You can take example of time bomb, or you can say missile launching. Fine, these are under the category of real-time operating system. Matlab, these type of operating system are basically used in case of medical also, or you can say some scientific purpose also. Okay, so that is real-time operating system. Okay, time bound would be there. In soft, maybe that process should be completed within time, but in hard, if that particular operating system is hard real-time, then that process should be completed at exact time. Fine. So that is all about types of operating system. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.